गुड आफ्टरनून माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द नेक्स्ट डिविजिबिलिटी टेस्ट, दैट इज डिविजिबिलिटी टेस्ट ऑफ 6 एंड 11। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी टेस्ट ऑफ 6। व्हाट इज टेस्ट ऑफ 6 और हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई वेदर द गिवन नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाय 6 और नॉट। See, there is not a special test for 6. You know, 6 means what? 6 means what? 2 multiplied by 3. 2 threes are 6, correct? So here, what is test of 6 or what? How to identify whether the given number is divisible by 6 or not? If the given number is divisible by 2 as well as 3. Understood? If the given number is divisible by 2 as well as 3, then the number will be divisible by 6. Clear means what? We have to check the given number, we have to check by 2 and by 3. If it is divisible by 2 as well as divisible by 3, then it will be automatically divisible by 6 also. Understood? We'll see. First, let us write the test. If the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3. Both 2 and 3, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. If it is divisible by 2 and not divisible by 3, then it will be not divisible by 6. Also, it is divisible by 2, it is divisible by 3 and it is not divisible by 2, then also it will not be divisible by 6. It must be divisible by both 2 and 3. Okay, so if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it will be divisible by 6. So this is the test of 6. The number should be divisible by both 2 and 3. Let's see the example. See, example we will see. For example, we will take one number 9,04,518. Okay, this is the number and we have to check whether this number is divisible by 6 or not. Okay, so as given in the test, the number should be divisible by 2 and 3. So here we have to apply the test of 2 and 3. We have to check by using test of 2 and 3. Now we have learned test of 2 and 3. Okay, what is test of 2? How to check whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not? If the last digit of the numbers, if the last digits of a number is or are 0 or 2, 4, 6 or 8. If the last digit of a number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the given number is divisible by 2. Now see here in this number, last digit is 8, correct? That means what? Its last digit is 8. So it is divisible by 2. Its last digit is 8, so it is divisible by 2, because divisibility of 2 says last digit must be, or ones place digit must be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then it will be divisible by 2, correct? So this is divisible by 2, fine. Now we will check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. So for to check that, we must know the divisibility test of 3. And what is divisibility test of 3 says? If the sum of digits is divisible by 3, then the given number is divisible by 3. So to check by 3, what we need to find first? Sum of the digits. So sum of digits means addition of all digits, 9 plus 0 plus 4 plus 5 plus 1 plus 8. So let's check the sum. 8 plus 1, 9 and 9, 18, correct? 9 and 9, 18. Then 5 plus 4, 9 again. So 18 and 9, 27 and 0, 27 itself. So the sum is 27. And this is the sum of the digits. Let's divide the sum by 3. 27 divided by 3. So 3 9 is 27. Yes, 27 is divisible by 3. That means sum is divisible by 3. That means this number is also divisible by 3. So it is divisible by 3. Now see here, this given number is divisible by 2 as well as it is divisible by 3. That means the given number is divisible by 6, since it is divisible by 2 and 3 also. Okay, so it is, or the number we write here, 9,4,518 is divisible by 6. Understood why it is divisible by 6? There is no separate or a special test for 6. We have applied test of 2 and then test of 3. And when we check by using test of 2 and 3, we found that the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So it is divisible by 6. Understood? So this is the DR test of 6. We will take one more example. This is first one. Okay, we have this number, 8,42,571. This is the number. Now see, first we will check by 2. We have to check whether this given number is divisible by 6 or not. For that, first we will apply test of 2. As test of 6 says, if the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it will be divisible by 6. So first we will check using test of 2. Now what test of 2 says? Check the last digit. If the last digit of the given number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the given number will be divisible by 2. So its last digit is 1. Or ones place digit is 1. Okay. So is it divisible by 2? No, it is. Its last digit is 1. Its last digit is 1. So it is not divisible by 2. It is not divisible by 2. Okay. This given number is not divisible by 2. As it is not divisible by 2, that means it will not be divisible by 6. Do we need to check by 3 again here? It is not divisible by 2. To become divisible by 6, it must be divisible by 2 as well as 3. Okay, so since it is not divisible by 2, so obviously it will not be divisible by 6. Okay, even though we will check whether it is divisible by 3, sum of the digits. Eight plus four plus 2 plus 5 plus 7 plus 1. So see here, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 5, 19, 19 and 1, 20 and 7, 27. See, sum is 27 and 27 is divisible by 3. We have seen 3 9s are 27, correct? So it is divisible by 3. It is divisible by 3. It is, this number is divisible by 3 but not divisible by 2. See, 8,42,571 is divisible by 3. But not divisible by 2. By 2, so it is not divisible by 6. Understood? See, this number is divisible by 3 but not divisible by 2, so it is not divisible by 6. So as we have seen the proper divisibility test of 6, it must be divisible by both 2 and 3, then only it will be divisible by 6. Okay, so whenever the question will be given, that check whether the given number is divisible by 6 or not, you have to apply test of 2 and test of 3, and if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then automatically it will be divisible by 6. Understood? So now pause this video and write this in your notebook. After this, you will see test of 11. Let's learn divisibility test of 11. So, how to identify whether the given number is divisible by 11 or not? See the test. First of all, we'll write the test. It is quite lengthy and complicated. Just you have to understand it properly. Once you understand, see the method, okay? When you read, you will not come to know, but when you will solve examples, observe that method, see that method and understand it, okay? So what test of 11 is, if the difference between the sum of the digits, sum of the digits at even places and odd places in a number should be zero or divisible by 11. Zero or divisible by 11, then the number is divisible by 11. Then the given number is divisible by 11. Not understood, right? Let's explain. Difference between the sum of the digits at even places and odd places. So we have to find the sum of the digits which are at even places and sum of the digits which are at odd places in the given number. And if that's difference, then we have to find the difference between those two sums. And the difference is, if you are getting the difference, zero or the number which is divisible by 11, that means the number which is multiple of 11, then the given number will be divisible by 11. See the example. When you see example, you will come to know. It's very easy. For example, 964,548. Okay, so this is the number, and we have to check whether this number is divisible by 11 or not. Now see, as given in the test, if the difference between the sum of the digits at even places and odd places. So first we have to find sum of the digits which are at even places and the sum of the digits which are at odd places. So now see, now even and odd means what? We have seen, do you remember, we have seen the numbers, even numbers and odd numbers. So the places means according to that number sequence. See, from the right side we will see, this is suppose one number, two number, third digit, fourth digit, fifth digit and sixth digit. Okay, so which digits in this number, which digits are at even places? Even places means the digits which are at even numbers. So even numbers means what? The numbers which are divisible by 2, correct? That is 2, 4 and 6. These digits are at even places. 2, 4 and 6, okay? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, whatever digits are there. And these digits are at even places. 1, 3 and 5, see. This is the first digit, this is third digit, this is fifth digits. Means they are at even places. And this is second, fourth and sixth. These digits occupy even places. Okay, and these odd places. One, third and first place, third place and fifth place. These digits occupy odd places. Okay, so we have to find sum of even places digits and then sum of odd places digits. See, sum of even places digit okay, so even places means the digit which are at second place, fourth place and sixth place, that is 6 plus 4 plus 9. What is the sum? 6 plus 4 10 and 9 19. Okay, let's find sum of odd places digits. That is 8 plus 5 plus 6. What is that? 8 plus 5, 13. 13 and 6, 19. See, sum of even places digits we got 19 and sum of odd places digits we got also 19. Now we have to find difference between these two sums. Difference between these sums, difference between these sums. See here, difference between these two sums. If the difference between the sums of the digits at even places and odd places in a number should be 0 or divisible by 11. So difference must, if the difference we are getting, that must be 0 or the number which is divisible by 11. So let's find the difference. 19 minus 19. What is 19 minus 19? 0. Are you getting difference 0?
Yes.
That means the difference is 0. So 964,568 is divisible by 11. Divisible by 11. Okay. Once again I explain, see here, first of all what we have to do, we have to mark the digits which are at even places and the digits which are at odd places. So first give them numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if there are more digits 7, 8, 9, whatever, okay. And then you know the odd numbers and even numbers, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, these are odd numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. These are even numbers, okay. So accordingly mark them. I have circled here even numbers digits and I have underlined the odd numbers, odd places digits. Then find the sum of even places digits. Then find the sum of odd places digits. Then difference between the sums. Find the difference between these two sums. So 19 minus 19, we got 0. Now the difference is 0 or multiple of 11, or the that means the number which is divisible by 11. Then the given number is divisible by 11, right? So here we got difference 0, so this number is divisible by 11. Let's see another example. Example number 2. 8,27,365. Suppose this is the number, okay? 8,27,365. Let's find sum of even places digits. Before that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And these are even places digits. And these are odd places digits, okay? So sum of even places digits is, see, even places means 6, 7 and 8. So see, 6 plus 7, 13, 13 and 8, 21, correct? 21. Sum of odd places digits that is 5 plus 3 plus 2. So 5 plus 3 plus 2, 5, 3 plus 2, 5 and 5, 10. Now we have to find difference between these two sums. Difference between this sum, that is 21 minus 10. 21 minus 10, 1 minus 0, 1 and 2 minus 1, 1, 11. We got difference 11, correct? So see, difference is 11. What is our divisibility test? The difference should be 0 or divisible by 11. So is 11 divisible by 11? Yes, all the numbers which comes in table of 11, that is 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22, 3s are 33, 4s are 44, 55, 66, 77, 88, 99 and so on. All these, the numbers which are multiple of 11 or the numbers which comes in table of 11, they are divisible by 11. So see, 11 ones are 11, 11 is divisible by 11. Since 11 is, or difference is divisible by 11, difference is, in bracket difference I am writing 11, this is divisible by 11. So 8,27,365 is divisible by 11. Okay? This is the divisibility test of 11. See, you will not just pause this video, write these two examples, test and these two examples. And the examples which I am giving for to solve, okay, for homework that you have to solve. When you solve more examples of these, automatically you will come to know, okay. The practice is most important. See the divisibility test of 6 and divisibility test of 11. It's quite complicated, so the practice is important. Only two tests I am taking today. So solve the examples which I am giving now. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me, okay? So thank you.